So we're filing these documents. This is a service sheet. And as you can see, this is Mount Fitzgerald, the Governor General. All right. And so we're filing these documents. Not only are we filing the actual application for a commission of inquiry, we also produce evidence already. We produce evidence. We produce evidence of.
This is for when they need to sign, if they don't have that.
Yeah, let me know when it's back. Make sure the cover is in a little bit. Yeah.
I'll just move it to the side then.
Yep.
Still reconnecting.
No.
But we're up on Coalition of Independence, Bahamian Evolution.
Oh, we have to go in this way.
So, Bahamas, we are here at the Office of the Governor General. And we are here so that Ms. Daxon and Mr. Bain can file a commission of inquiry on behalf of the Bahamian people.
The taxpayers.
Into the National Insurance Fund.
That's what this is all about, my fellow Bahamians. We are here now. We are going to deliver a letter to the Governor General, asking the Governor General to ask this new PLP government to launch a commission of inquiry to state where our taxpayers' money is going. We, the Bahamian people, have a problem with what is going on in this country. And we got to now stand up and say enough is enough. We need some answers. And the only time we're gonna ever get answers is when the government do their job and investigate what happened to our monies. Lincoln.
Yeah, so we have our service sheet and we have documents here and we also have evidence in here that we're presenting to them. Some unreleased that we're presenting to the Governor General. We're also going to be serving the Prime Minister and the Minister responsible for national insurance, which is Miles Zerota. But first, we decided to come here to this because the responses by the Progressive Party through their chairman and especially by NIB is extremely concerning to us.
Yes.
Because it was very deceitful and they seem to be running from the truth. And so we're going to have to take action. All right.
But Lincoln, did you tell them about this? See, Bahamians, it's the same document. This is a conveyance, right? And look at it. Entry date, the 3rd of September, 2014. These are documents that was filed, my fellow Bahamians.
They're not denied it.
Thank you. They're not denying it. Everything is here. Why they took NIB number to purchase all this property.
NIB money
to purchase all these properties on Skyline Drive. What benefit it is to the Bahamian people? Huh? Who does benefit, Lincoln? It sure didn't benefit the taxpayers and the workers.
On Sunday at 5 o'clock when we go live, we're going to show you even more scandalous stuff that the Governor General will know, and you will find out on Sunday. All right, so that's what we're here to do. So we're going to serve this, and then we're going to talk to you on some more. And we have to go to the Prime Minister and to the Minister responsible for. Gotta get a mask. I forget, we still living
under a flag. Yes, Bahamians, while we're waiting for Lincoln to go and get his mask, Bahamians, I always tell you, I'll be coming with documents between the Treasurer of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and the National Insurance Board. And this got incorporated in 2000. Bahamians, when you look at this, see, the vendor had agreed with the purchaser for the sale of $3 million. $3 million of NIB money. that they agree. Right here, Bahamian, we don't have to lie about nothing. We are now going to drop this off to the Governor General.
Thank you.
Means we are really not
It's trying to reconnect on us, I guess.
So the thing is, we are ready now.
Yeah.
I want to see about that. I want to think I had time for it, but together.
Hello. Good day.
Can we see you on the end
road?
Oh, yes.
Yes. Thank you.
Right. Right. Good day.
No, no, the station, man. Not so sweet.
Oh, my God.
Thank
you. Oh, no, we've got to put cameras on me just in case I get off. No, hold on. They got to put it on the...
We did it very much. So we have put paperwork and documentation together. Make sure I don't point at them. We'll put our documentation together, and we're presenting documentation, etc. to the Governor General, so that the Commission of Inquiry will be finally filed. Every single administration, you would see the government accusing the previous government of skullduggery as relates to NIB. Another government comes in, they accuse another one of skullduggery, but none of them would ever file a Commission of Inquiry or do any proper investigation. Now, the citizens of the Bahamas, an official organization, our organization, has filed actual Commission of Inquiry into the dealings at the National Insurance Board. Why is our money being spent on homes, on vacant lots? That, you know, we heard the chairman of the Progressive Party say that these lots, well, the one property he mentioned, which was to be the office of the Prime Minister, was to be renovated. But that's from how long ago now? How long ago was that? It's more than a decade. That was purchased, what, in 2007? And this is now 2022, and it was supposed to be renovated. What happened to that money? Since then, Ingram came in, Perry went back in, Minnis came back in. Nothing. This is out of order. And all we're saying is, if we as Bahamians are going to be arrested because we don't pay our NIB. If you're an entrepreneur, you're supposed to pay NIB for yourself, self-employed. If you don't pay it, you get arrested. Okay? Or there's some sanctions against you. If you're a business person, you don't pay the NIB, you get arrested, you get dragged before the courts. If it is that serious, then why is it that our money can be spent on things like derelict, rundown vehicles where if you walk on the floor, you're going to fall, not vehicles, buildings. If you walk on the floor, you're going to fall to the floor. Buildings from the 1800s. Yes, buildings that old. Buildings from the early 1900s that are not antique buildings. There's no excuse for this kind of malfeasance, especially when the government has proposed to increase national insurance by 2% every other year for the next 14 years. That increases national insurance by 28%. Now this is the catch. It's already 9.8%. So now, that's
38%.
Because what it does is it starts to crop over, all right? And so we thought we'd not do it again. And then after we publicized it, they realized that to lose an official document to the Governor General, which means that you're losing an official document to the Queen, all right? That's an official document. That is a serious breach. And so they call us back and say, okay, they have it. And they wrote us a response, all right? A late response. We'll see how late the response is going to be on this NIB matter. We think that we hit a sore point because we had NIB replying the live. Now, the live may go off for a minute because we're going in the elevator. And it may lose signal, all right? Come. Get as fast as possible. So hopefully the live doesn't go down because we're in the elevator. If it does, we just get it right back up. But these official documents know exactly what is going on.
Thank you. I think the Minister of National Security is not alive again because it was forced to end it after being like this for like 2 minutes.
Okay, sorry to interrupt for that connection for a minute.
But
we're going to be officially
going
to be 5 minutes for one from her on this. Now becomes an international incident. Now becomes an international. Our natural resources have been raped and robbed. And there's some people who are saying, you know, there are people who are saying things like, oh, y'all are talking about so many different things. I said, we have a country to run, and a country is dynamic. There's so many different levels of things. There's education, there's crime, all right? There's tourism, there's healthcare. There's all manner of things that we as an organization have to deal with. We cannot just only deal with any one thing. And so we're not going to just be talking about natural resources. We're not going to only be talking about crown land, which also is a natural resource. Some people don't understand. Land is the number one natural resource, and all natural resources are found in land. All right? Even the ocean is on top of land. And so we're filing all of these documents. We're going to be dealing with what has to be dealt with in this country. But the major thing we are dealing with in everything is corruption.
Thank you.
Because it is our major problem in this country. So now we're headed, where are we headed? La Rota or off to the Prime Minister?
La Rota.
We're headed to La Rota. You can tell her where to go.
Yes. West Bay Street. Not West Bay Street. That's East Bay Street. We go in the area to fish fry.
Alright, that's East Bay Street. Yeah, let them know we're coming.
Yeah,
let them know we're coming. Yeah, La Rota, we're coming. Because I know you're watching it. Coming.
Yeah, I like La Rota.
All right, so.
And by the way, he parents are from the South Islands. That's the South Island, yeah.
That might be your family.
Oh, no, he my family. No, he too light skin.
Yeah.
No, but he nice. And, you know, they need some things in place, and we look for him to change some stuff, make the correction to really what is going on in this country.
And while we're here, I want to take a pause to thank the actual Davis administration for two things that they recently did in the last couple of days. Because if we can criticize, we can also commend Maria. They actually implemented another one of our plans. It seems like they are trying to implement as much of our plans as possible.
No, but we talked to the Bahamian people.
Yeah.
So it's Bahamian people glad.
Of course. I just want to let them know the origin.
Right.
It belongs to Bahamian people. So we don't mind. They can implement all our plans.
Thank you.
Once we benefit. And one of them is the taxi. The taxi
yes.
drivers have gotten their plate. We actually met with the taxi drivers.
Yes,
the
we
union
did.
Before the election to let them know our plans and what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. And we like that the Davis administration put some of those things in place by giving some of those people who were leasing taxi plates, they actually gave them taxi plates, which is
yes,
a good thing.
Yes.
And so we were happy for that. Also, they changed the amount of years you have to wait to declare a missing loved one dead to 2 years instead of 7 years. That was also a good thing.
Yes.
There are many persons who were affected in Abaco by what happened there at Dorian. I know Charlotte was a Dorian survivor. She had to go through that, walk through that water and brave that storm. And so we're glad that those things took place. Mm-hmm. However, there's much more to be done.
Yes.
All right? We're not satisfied with these little trinkets. And we're not going to be praising politicians for doing their job. We highly pay them to do their job. I do not want to see any politician trying to get credit for fixing a pothole or fixing roads. All right? Giving us our taxi plate, that's your job. All right? You didn't do nothing special. Of course, others didn't do it, but you didn't do anything special. That's your job. That's what needs to happen. Now, in giving the taxi drivers taxi plate, we want to ask them to fix something else. The bus drivers need to be looked at, right? The bus drivers need to be looked at right away. One of the things I can say, they said that they're going to give a little stipend to the bus drivers. They're going to give some money to the bus drivers, Maria, because the bus drivers want to increase the bus fare, but the government doesn't want to increase the bus fare. So the government's going to give stipend to the bus drivers. Now, the bus driver isn't paying the mortgage for that bus. The bus driver doesn't have all of the expenses, gas, fuel, etc. for that bus.
Yeah.
It's the owner of the bus. The drivers just drive. Right? Some of them get a salary, some of them pay the owner a certain amount of being just to use the bus, but I don't think they thought that fully through. And so you're not helping by giving the bus driver extra, because the owner still needs some money. All right, because he got to buy parts. He got to fix that bus. You know, he got to do certain things. So when you don't have a plan like we had, when you don't have a plan, because we had a plan for the transportation system in this country, for the bus system.
Yes.
But of course, the progressive party doesn't have a plan. So when you don't have a plan, you do stuff like this without thinking it through. All right, but back to what we are here to talk about. We have officially, if you're just tuning in, we have officially filed for a commission of inquiry to the Governor General. It was received by Jack Thompson, the permanent secretary, and we didn't announce it because we didn't want them preparing and doing no stuff that way. Right? And we're also going to send some documents to the Queen herself, reference to the previous commission of inquiry that we applied for, and they ignored. Philip Brave Davis was asking for commission of inquiries while he was in opposition, but notice, none. He's in power and able to do it now, but notice, none. Oh, we need a commission inquiry on Abaco and the Dorian situation. Notice, there's none. Because they pretend to be different and they pretend to be fighting against one, but in reality, all of them are working together. All right? So, Maria, National Insurance basically is saying that people need to check the validity or the truth of whatever when they get it, but they can't say anything that we said is not true.
But Lincoln, we have filed documents here. And Lincoln, I want to bring this to the Bahamian people's attention, mm-hmm. Right? I mean, looking at this document, it's conveyance. Two of the properties they said sell after they purchase it, they sell it for $10. Who these properties was for?
No, what happened is they authorized the sale.
Yeah.
To do this, they have to do it in the House of Assembly.
Right.
They authorized the sale, and the House of Assembly said, the House of Assembly and the Bahamian public was deceived and told that this would be sold for $10.
Right.
You can't sell from the government to NIB, which is still government, you know, a property that's already owned by government. You can't sell to yourself. All right, even though NIB is a separate entity, all right, legally, but it's clearly skullduggery. So and when they presented to the House of Parliament, it was said we have authorization to sell it for the consideration of $10. But it was sold for $3 million instead.
Oh, man, they can't be this deceitful, man.
That sale is void.
Oh my God, but Lincoln, I look at this, I was like, why would you have $10 for two of these properties, mm-hmm. and then you have $3 million in the front? Why would you write up a document like this for consideration for $10? Bahamians, I am so sorry. We need this commission of inquiry.
That right there is criminal.
Thank you very much.
That's fraud. And that's the seat of the Bahamian people, and someone needs to pay.
Thank you very much.
So someone asked a question. Why are we bringing up this old stuff? All right, as if it's old. The truth of the matter is, this is just some. Again, we're spoon feeding. This shows what they were doing with our stuff.
Yes.
And the result is that we are now talking about the fund being in crisis.
Thank you.
To the point where it could collapse. So this is not old. All right? It's not old. If you had intercourse 10 years ago and now you see you get AIDS, you can't say the intercourse is old.
Thank you very much.
You would not have the other thing.
Thank you.
But for them squandering our money on investments like this, we would not be in this state where it is affecting us today.
Thank you.
It is affecting us right now. Because there are people trying to claim from NIB now and they're being stalled with all kind of excuses.
Thank you.
The NIB staff wants their money, their pay. They want their industrial agreement, their new contract. 2 years is gone, more than 2 years, and they can't get it.
Thank
because
you.
The government is telling them there's no money.
Thank you.
There's no money with y'all board, Darren and Coombs. If you spent $6.6 million on 3 homes, plus all these properties we're talking about, plus some
Thank you very
homes,
much.
Then go sell them. Go sell them mm-hmm. and get our money back.
Thank you very much.
But that's where they can't sell them.
But Lincoln,
Maria,
I know.
Because there's another problem that we can tell them on Sunday. This goes deep.
But Lincoln, you know what else is so surprising? They're wondering where we get these documents from. The people are upset. They are now dropping the documents in our lap because they say they are tired with both governments taking the workers' money out of NIB and do as they please.
Maria, if it's one thing the government knows, is that me and you were very good investigators.
Thank you very
we
much.
We are well-trained investigators.
They train us.
Yeah.
The police force train us.
Yeah, that's when my training began.
Yes.
So they know we are very good investigators, and they see it every time we come forward. We don't come forward without proof.
Lincoln, you want to tell them the story? Tell them how some police has been giving us information. Good afternoon, my fellow Bahamians. Arjuna Kagal, is it true when you were working in NIB under Shane Gibson that you discovered that $15 million was in Central Bank on hold by NIB? And you asked for them to return the money. And that's when you and Shane Gibson fall out. Is that true, Arjuna Kagal? Do you know anything about the other $15 million of the workers' money? Huh?
I'm telling them everything. We can save it for Sunday.
Huh?
Sunday, 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
We can save it. All right? We got a lot more for y'all. But NIB was being very deceitful. Very deceitful in their response, and anyone with an odica of common sense can see that. They actually reached out to us and we didn't say.
Thank you. We didn't even know about it, Lincoln. Mm. That's the problem. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, but the houses, we know about the houses.
Thank you.
Yeah, we definitely know about all of this.
Thank right. you.
Now, them confessing that they spent $2.2 million. How can you spend $2.2 million on a house that literally you need to just go there and kick that wall and the house fall down?
Okay.
These run down dilapidated homes that you spent our money on. Y'all said the price. Y'all said the value. Not us. Y'all.
Lincoln, did you show this other document what the research team found?
No, let him know.
Okay. Kyle, you want to talk about this document? The $37 million? Tell the Bahamian people. You remember this?
All right. So, here we have a document that is from the Nassau Guardian. In 2020, the Nassau Guardian the Nassau Guardian published an article about some Bahamian
bonds
that NIB gave a loan for. So,
who was the prime minister there?
Apparently, that was Minnis, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So apparently, NIB gave a loan that can be used for these bank bonds.
How much money it was?
$37 million.
On what bank?
No, this one wasn't BOB. This one was given on behalf of, it says, you know, D'Aguilar spoke about it.
D'Aguilar? Who? Mm-hmm. Speak up, Cara. Who spoke about this?
The Minister of Tourism, D'Aguilar, uh-huh. led off the debate on behalf of the Deputy Prime Minister.
Who was the Deputy Prime Minister? Peter Turnquest.
Yes, Peter Turnquest. Who at the time was in self-quarantine.
Okay, right here. What bank saying that is? Read that to the Bahamian people.
The Bahamas Development Bank.
Really? So Lincoln, this is another bank. They bailing out. Your mama was the Bank of the Bahamas.
Yep.
Now, Dr. Minnis, could you tell the Bahamian people what y'all doing with $37 million of NIB money to the Bahamas Development Bank? Wow. Huh? Kyle, you sure it's the right thing?
Yes, and Deputy Leader Chester Cooper, he was asking about the transparency of the bond conversion.
Who?
Deputy Leader Chester Cooper, the Progressive Liberal Party Deputy Leader.
Yes. The image, you see it? I, Chester Cooper, was asking about the transparency of the bond conversion. Huh? Read what Elsie say.
I'll say off the top that I have no objection to this bill, nor the objective as described. It's nothing too complex. It appears to be a restructuring of the balance sheet of the bank by refinancing the bond with a government guarantee debt. I get the underlying financial gyration. I will say, though, that I am offended that the government would bring such a resolution without the bank's financials.
Hold on. Make it hear what I say.
Without the bank's financials.
Do you guess what's going on? Didn't bring any documents.
Wow.
And I, Chester Cooper, stated this. Finish reading.
If you don't have up-to-date audited financial statements at a minimum, bring the management accounts, he said.
Hey, did you hear this? They don't even have up-to-date management account. When I, Chester Cooper, in the People's Parliament, asking certain things. See? Asking certain things.
How you doing, man? All right.
Okay.
All right. You too, man. You too. All right. Okay, all right. Thank you, man. God bless.
So, Bahamas, you see what's going on?
He says more.
What all he said?
He said, in the private sector, it is highly unusual and frowned upon to be asked to restructure a balance sheet without actually seeing the balance sheet. So you come to Parliament, your board of directors, who represent your shareholders, the Bahamian people, and asked us to act blindly.
You serious? You sure I, Chester Cooper, said that?
It's in Nassau Guardian. You gotta ask them.
How come since they come to power, Chester Cooper ain't saying nothing about this?
That's a good question, Mr. Bain.
Yeah, they ain't saying nothing about this.
Oh, you know what
it's as if it didn't happen.
Thank you. Yeah. You know what we need to do? We need, Carl, you need to print up what I, Chester Cooper, had to say.
Yes, huh?
You need to print that off. I put that right there.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we are at the National Insurance Board. And so, this is where we are now. To support them and be behind them, then that is absolutely on y'all. We would have done our part.
Amy's been going upstairs now, like Lincoln said, to see the Honorable Miles Corona. He is in charge of National Insurance, and we, on behalf of the Bahamian people, need some answers. What happened to the workers' money in this country? Amy, it's a cadet. It's a Bahamian thing. All the Bahamian flags.
Second block. Thank you. All right. Okay. So again, we might lose signal. We might lose signal because we're going in elevator.
Thank you.
Oh my God. Is Michael over here?
What?
Okay. My fellow Bahamians.
How you doing?
In the front of National Disaster, the building is nice. It's a Bahamian people thing. This is the Prime Minister, the Honorable Gray Davis. This is the Governor General, C.A. Smith. And the Minister, Miles Rota. This is who we come here to go have let deliver to.
These are the three people we're serving.
Yeah, these are the three persons we are serving.
Good afternoon.
Oh my God, I've seen everybody who I knew I know. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. How can I help?
You came to see, you can drop off a package for the Minister, Miles Rota.
The Minister is not in.
Okay.
Can I receive it for him?
Sure.
You need me to sign it?
Of
yes,
course.
That's official service.
Official service. I don't know what's going on, my phone, but my phone, how can I make it yours today?
I believe the Minister of National Security targeting y'all.
I don't think so. We can get our message out. Ma'am, could you put the date and the time, please? Yes, we are waiting. The lady is signing for the letter for the minister.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Right,
so
have
much.
A nice day.
You too.
All right.
And by the way, tell that person in the back who knows me, I say hi. One of my squad mates is in the back.
You can tell me that yourself.
Where's this fellow? You?
All right, so we've officially served on the Governor General, and we've served on Mazda Road Up. And so
Next, we're going to be serving down the road on the office of the Prime Minister.
Yes.
All right? And so we're giving them all the evidence they need, all right, to get this done. National insurance has been used as a computer.
Abuse also.
And we received documentation where.
Thank you.
Point it up. We received documentation where.
I know it's going to come back up.
All right, thank you. All right, bro.
Have a good day.
What do you mean? Every time I look at this, these people are going to be purchasing everything.
Thank you.
But I'm going to know. What is Carol?
Carol.
You see what this is? This is another?
Yeah. 110 on signing care of the Carib Insurance.
Look at this.
It is important to note that Mr. Ward did not disclose the board of directors to the board of directors any particulars of the Carib
purchase.
And the fact that the relevant sales purchase agreement was signed on June 22nd, 2007. Also absent from the disclosure by Mr. Ward was the fact that Bahamas First had not yet received approval to finalize acquisition of 100% of outstanding shares of Caribbean Seas Limited, et cetera, et cetera. We'll deal with that.
Yes, we'll deal with this. I guess the Bahamas First again. Link and install this stuff.
Bahamas First is very familiar.
Yes. All of them are ignorant of the national insurance.
Yeah.
Money. Beam, is this one of these documents getting dropped? You're always in the insurance business too? No, man.
Yeah.
Oh, behemoths. They really was raping and robbing us.
Uh-uh. When you're now talking about.
Thank you.
Why we gotta suffer for your actions? You know exactly what's been happening. You all know what cover up you all been doing. All right. And one thing we have
is documents.
Plenty documents. All right. And so that was Miles Abroda. He is the MP for Pinewood Gardens, also the place where I born and raised. Well, grow up, not born.
Yeah.
The place where I grew up and the place where Maria grew up.
That's right.
All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, it took a young man from Pinewood Gardens to come and give them the idea and the plan for how to fix the flooding in Pinewood. We'll see if they do it. But we heard they're going to do it because they see there's a political threat and they want to deliver something in Pinewood. So, thanks to us, Pinewood is finally going to get their flooding problem fixed because of the threat of a Pinewood young man coming up and taking it over and fixing it. And a Pinewood young man had to come and give them the solution how to do it. They're talking about the brick system and they do it in the Netherlands, etc. They are taking the plan that we presented, where you put the reserve, the reservoir under the park, etc. And they're taking all of our plans and using it. But if Pinewood can benefit, I don't care. That's all I want. I'm not here for politics. No. I am here for Bahamian people benefiting. Because if we had a government that was looking out for the people, I could have been doing something else right now. All right, there's plenty I could have been doing with my day. But we don't have a government that is looking out for our people. And so we're going to put more plans out there piece so that they can take it and use it for our people's benefit. Really and truly, Maria, you know we actually govern in this country right now. Because everything they're doing is either our plans or they're doing in response to us.
We make it as long as they get it done.
Yeah.
As long as they get it done. We can be the persons who can check and balance these governments. Because Lincoln, if our parents, our grandparents, and our great-grandparents did this, we would have had this problem what we have in today. Things need to change in this country. And what is so sad is Lincoln, they were getting rich off our parents' them labor. Huh?
Yeah.
They labor. Huh? My mother used to do a cleaning job to survive in this country. Huh? My daddy had to go do their deliveries to survive while these persons in power just stealing, raping, and robbing from their own people. Lincoln, all this benefit was here, was supposed to be spread, but they made sure that only a select set of people benefit from the people's things.
Yes.
Huh? This wasn't their things, you know. It wasn't the government things. It was the people's things. Because the government make up, the people make the government.
Yeah.
Huh? The government ain't the people, you know. The people is the government.
And Marie, I want you to understand something. If we wasn't here right now with this weak FNM party they have with Michael
Bissad,
who has no say even in his own party, if he wasn't here, this government would have been running amok right now.
You're lying.
The only reason they inject is because we exist, and it's because they know we will come after them.
Thank you.
If they do anything out of order.
I agree.
The illegals started flooding the Bahamas in September, right after the election. They started ignoring it until they heard
he was going to Inagua.
Our team was coming down to Inagua.
Yes.
Because at first they made an excuse and said, "Oh, the Haitian airport didn't allow us to land there." The Haitian airport been closed for many decades. What they were talking about, lying. But when they heard we hit the ground, all of a sudden, they packed them people up and they sent them home, and we stayed right there and watched them. All right? We have been keeping their foot to the fire, and we will continue to do so.
On behalf of the Bahamian people.
Of us.
Thank you.
And I just want to make this clear. We are going to fight until we have the Bahamas where we are first.
Thank you.
What we're doing. We are going to fight. This year, I'm going to have to say this. I am absolutely, positively boycotting the independence period this year. We are not truly independent, and we are living a second, fourth class, fifth class citizens in our own country. We are living below everybody else. What is there to celebrate? What is there to celebrate when we have a country that allows other people to be proud of their flag in our country? When the law says that if they fly their flag, they should fly ours. What is there to be proud of when everyone else can take our land, do what they want with it, trespassing our land? But you're attacking the Bahamians. What is there to be proud of when they can build whatever structures they want to, however they want to? But if you try to build an enclosure for your garbage in front of your yard, they will come and break it down. All right? What is there to be proud of when we can't benefit from all these natural resources we have that we're going to now talk to the Queen about? What is there to be proud of? I don't see anything to be proud of.
When the government even keeps it secret away from us, they're not even allowing us to have freedom of information in our own country, my home. I am not allowed information to, but yet I am a Bahamian. What is there to be proud of? What is there to celebrate? I can't even partake in the bountiness of my own country. What is there to be proud of?
So, Lincoln, you're putting on the Bahamian colors?
Listen, that's my colors. I'll put that on anytime I want.
Okay.
But I am not celebrating in independence. Okay.
And we're looking at all these signs around Nassau, around the roundabout. I am proud to be Bahamian. And all of those pictures depict slavery.
Yeah.
All of them depict slavery, Lincoln. Workers. I don't see nothing there that talks about a scientist, a Bahamian scientist, and it's possible we could have it. I don't see anything there that talks about a marine biologist. We could have it. I don't see anything there that states pride and ownership. Everything we see around the roundabout shows Bahamian workers and not Bahamian owners. Mm-hmm. I want to be a owner in my country without being restricted.
Slavery and jobs. That's all they promote. We have Fred Mitchell voice note. He sent up with me, so I need to get a job. Listen, that's their mentality. Fred Mitchell is 68. All right? That's their mentality. All right? That's their mentality. Jobs. I'm not interested in your jobs. You're interested in empowering Bahamians.
Yeah.
It's time to empower Bahamians. Jobs? Let me tell you something, yeah. Fred. You have been making money off the Bahamian people all your life. You are a political slave. All right? You never run a business. You never had a real job in your life. You, Fred Mitchell. All you do is run from politics. When you're in, you make your money. Then when you're out, you live until you come back in. You suffer and you struggle until you come back in. We are tired of this. We don't want this for our children. We don't want this for our future. We want a Bahamas that we can benefit from. Give us our natural resources. You're talking about $100,000. What if it's more, Fred Mitchell?
Thank you.
It's actually distributed, whatever the profits are, distributed to our people. A percentage of all the profits made off of our natural resources. It might be more.
Thank you very much.
It might be more. And so we are going to benefit from our natural resources. We are.
But Lincoln, you know what is so shocking to me? When the Queen left this country and she handed over everything to the government on behalf of the Bahamian people, Lincoln, is our own people who treated us badly, you know. It was our own people who went in there, tried to deprive everything that the Queen leave to benefit us. It was our own people, Lincoln. It was like they had a problem with us benefiting from our things. This was killing me, you know. It wasn't like these white people, because I expected that from them white people.
Yeah.
But not our own man, Lincoln.
Let me make this clear to you. The Queen was given hundreds and thousands of acres
of land.
Bahamian people.
Thank you.
Giving it. They are Bahamians with actual deeds. Right. With title grants. With royal grants. All right? They are Bahamians with grants from the Queen herself. All right? From the Queen herself. They are Bahamians with grants. All right? And so, even under the UBP,
thank you.
Was getting right. what was theirs. But when our own black people take over, Jesus Lord, some things change. When our own black people.
That's right.
All right, when our own black people
the big
took
one.
Over problems.
You're lying, Lincoln.
They said these black people don't deserve to have all this land.
Thank
they
you very
all
much.
This land. We literally have deeds in our hands of black Bahamian families that
That's
have
right.
been raped and robbed of their land.
From our own black government.
Governments with an S.
Yeah, governments.
Especially that Hubert Ingram.
Thank you. Boy, Papa, I love you so much. Papa, let me tell you something. You see, Lincoln tricked me, Papa. When Lincoln gave me them documents, Lincoln couldn't tell me that your name is in that document, Papa. Lincoln, make sure I get on the site, and when I start reading and I see Hubert Ingham Esquire, my heart stopped. I said, look how Lincoln tricked me, because Lincoln didn't know I have a special love in my heart for you. But when I saw these documents, Papa, I can't believe this. Not the Papa who I didn't know. I didn't love and respect.
And so we want some answers. We want answers. We want a commission of inquiry. Remember, Philip Brave Davis actually was the chairman of the National Insurance Board while Shane Gibson was the minister. All right, 2002 to 2007, and between that period, Philip Brave Davis was the chairman, because he wanted to be a backbencher at the time because he was still doing some law stuff. He was the chairman of the National Insurance Board. So he knows a lot of stuff, Maria.
Yes, he does.
And when he was chairman, that's when they didn't even declare what the reserves are.
Who was Chairman Blinker?
Philip Brave Davis.
You serious?
They did not declare what the reserves are.
Oh, Lincoln, yes. After I read those documents,
yeah.
I realized after 2012, they never declared what the reserve
not
was.
Before 2012.
Right. They never declare what the reserve was.
That's
they never declare
mm-hmm.
how much money they collected, and mm-hmm. they never declare how much money they paid out.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So why you think the PLP government was hiding that? Huh?
The hiding started from Ingram.
Right.
Right before that. But at least Ingram was still saying what the reserve was.
Was.
And then at one point, while him and Shane was there, they stopped. All right? And then afterwards, when they weren't there, they declared the reserve again. And so these are the kinds of things. We could break this down for y'all on Sunday because there's more to talk about. We could break this down on Sunday at 5 o'clock for y'all. We have some more. We're headed to the office of the Prime Minister to serve this final summons on him. But, man, we've been going through too much as a people, man. People think we're doing this because we want attention. Really, you want attention, eh?
No, Lincoln.
You got things to be doing, right?
I get things. Lincoln, I have 3 clients and I had to cancel out today. Why? Because it's about the Bahamian people. Huh? This is about country, you know, Lincoln. Mm-hmm. We're doing this for country. We have some children. Mm-hmm. And, you know, my daughter told me this morning, it's nothing like the Bahamas.
Wow.
I said, baby, you're going to be a nurse. You need to go away. No, it's nothing like the Bahamas. I am coming home, mommy. I don't care where I go. So you listen to my daughter looking at me. Lincoln, I keep telling y'all I want them to go away. Just to press the button. They ain't leaving. So I need to fight for them.
We can't let our children go away no more. You know, we gotta build. See, we fail if we don't build a home for our children. We also fail if we don't build a country for our children. If we don't have a country that our children would want to come back to or can come back to, we fail as a nation. Our children are now leaving and going elsewhere.
Yes.
I don't want to be in the Bahamas. No, we got to fight for this. Some people think we just want to be prime minister, deputy prime minister, etc. Listen, I never had interest in politics. Neither
me neither.
Never had interest in politics.
Nigga, why don't you tell them the truth? You was the one who had to bring me in this forefront.
Mm-hmm. And Maria was tension straight through.
I was tension. I said, Lincoln, I don't want to do this. He said, but the people. It was
who
about.
Who else is going to fight?
Thank
who
you.
Who else is going to stand up?
See?
You could imagine me and Maria Daxon in the House of Assembly right now. That place would be in check.
Thank you very much.
That place would be in check.
And they would bring us documents to prove what they have to say. Huh?
We would table bills and force it on them because any MP could table a bill.
Thank you.
We would force them to do what is right.
Thank you.
So we just had to make one stop. And we're headed to the office of the Prime Minister to give Brave his documents. Brave in this country yet? Brave, yeah, he's gone somewhere. Brave never yet. Brave, we are friends.
Yeah, look here. I give it up. Listen to me, Lincoln. People are telling me, Daxon, why I am looking for the PLP to make things better in this country. Huh? Yes, I'm giving
this. If they do right, all of us win.
Right.
We're not against them. Whenever they do right, we're going to tell them, yes, you did right.
Thank you.
Just like how we did in this life. All right? You did some good stuff.
Yes. I want the PLP to succeed in this game. Why? Because Lincoln, that can make life easier for me and you. We would have to be out there making noise.
Yeah.
I tired.
But you can't be coming in power. Coming in power, and then right away you're giving housing project to our homes.
Frankie the Snake Wilson. Yeah.
With no tender, no bidding process, no nothing. Just give it to our homes.
Yeah.
To pay them off. That's the same old corruption again, man.
Yeah.
We're not having that.
And you know, we ain't too much like Frankie the Snake, because you know me, did our parents come home and cause all that damage?
Maria was a victim.
Thank you.
I was a victim of Pinewood, and so was I.
Thank you.
I was a victim of Pinewood Gardens. All right? They made billions of dollars by what they did to our family.
Thank you.
By what they did to our parents. They made billions of dollars doing it. All right?
I lost over 100 pairs of shoes to swamp. All the water came up in my mother's house when I went to school in London. Come back. She sent me the pictures after her knee. Wow. Huh? And I asked her, I said, Mommy, where are my shoes? She said, shoes? He's fighting for our life. She said me, huh? The furniture's them were swimming. And I said, the furniture's were swimming. You Frankie the Snake. And you think we can let you all do? It's the other.
Yeah, hello, school. We need a reserve sheet. Is this secretary here? Is this one secretary to meet me? Yes, the means we are here. He came to deliver the letter to the prime minister with regards to a court of inquiry reference to find out what happened to the workers' money at the NIB. His secretary, is the secretary here? So we wait to speak to the prime minister's secretary to make sure that she gets this document and to put it in the prime minister's hand, because we, the Bahamian people, we need some answers. Billions and billions of the workers' money are unaccounted for at NIB. We cannot have this. Because in another couple of years, there will be no money in NIB for the Bahamian people to collect when they retire. They get what you want to say, because we retired.
Yeah, we have done our part. We have served the Commission of Inquiry. We've officially applied the Commission of Inquiry. We've presented them with documents, with evidence. How can Parliament say to buy a property or sell a property for $10, but then it turns around and you do it for $3 million, plus other transactions that we don't see any transaction in the House of 74. We do more investigations, but NIB came forward and talked about spending $2.2 million on three homes. I don't see that transaction in the House of Assembly. Maybe it was there. I didn't see it. All right. So with these kind of things, you know, they invested in the brewery.
What brewery? What kind of brewery?
Yeah. So they invested in the brewery. How do you invest in an alcohol company as national insurance with all of the health issues that alcohol, the use of alcohol, causes? How could you then invest in an alcohol company when you're going to be causing the, while you may get some dividends from it, maybe, you're causing more harm? I don't know. You're causing more harm because now more people are now going to be getting ill and sick because of your investment in it. You know, these are the kinds of things we can't have.
Mr. Bain, could you please read this to the Bahamian people, what Loretta Butler, Turner said, and Mr. Shane Gibson? Read from him. I'm shocked to see that.
She said, the Bahamian people fully understand exactly what I am saying. It appears, Mr. Speaker, that the pension fund of the Bahamian people, the pension fund in an NIB, of the Bahamian people that is deposited in NIB is being used to bail out friends, companions, lovers, and PLP supporters in a private entity. I have no difficulty with those people being satisfied, but you cannot go and bail out people who have misused and misappropriated funds and try to make good with the public.
Tell the baby what Loretta Butler was trying to say to the PLP.
That you are thieving the money.
That's right. I give it to who?
Your friends, family, lovers, companions, and PLP supporters. That's kind of like in the Crown Land where we are now.
Yeah.
They literally came and put some signs up allegedly, right? Well, you know, I'm surprised when you say I didn't see this. They put some signs up, but they didn't put it in the area
where
the PLP and the ladies are.
So let me put it up there. Well, we are the Bahamian people.
They ain't put it where the PLB got it from, and they ain't put the signs where the Haitian are. So what Greg David is saying is that.
And who signed it?
Who? Greg David signed it.
Wow.
Tom Ryan is now only for
PLBs.
PLB generals and Haitians. Not all PLBs, but some plenty with us.
Right.
But it's for PLB generals and Haitians.
Yeah.
Haitian signed it. Take time to bear.
She signed it already.
She signed it? Okay, all right, thank you.
Thank you. Have a nice evening.
Right. Thank you.
So the problem with this guy here. This was here when you come here?
No, this just pull up.
Thank you.
Oh, just pull up ahead.
Yeah. All right, so.
We're
going to touch on that because, you know, I just want to say while we're at the office of the Prime Minister, I just want to make this clear to you all.
Yeah.
They put up some signs allegedly, right? Lying on it. But they put up some signs allegedly, right? Saying that people shouldn't enter, remove trees, etc. in the forest. Now, they didn't declare that a forest. Now, first and foremost, it's signed by Brave Davis. Brave Davis, you are not the Minister of Environment, right?
Or Forestry.
All right? You are not the Director of Forestry. And so for you to sign that, that shows there's something wrong with you all up here, all right? It looks like the Minister of Environment is not cooperating with them anymore, and no one else in Cabinet could sign that, Maria, and so that's why the PM had to sign it, to deceive the Bahamian public. There's some official thing, you see? And so what we want them to do, if you all say that, remember all this talk about we trespassing and this and that and whatever on Crown Land, or when it's against the law, if we trespass on Crown Land, put up your sign saying we trespassing on Crown Land. And Brave Davis can sign that because he's in charge of Crown Land, but that ain't what they put up. If it's unlawful for us to be on the Crown Land, put up the sign saying we trespassing on Crown Land. Don't trick the Bahamian people. All right, don't trick
them. But it's only for us. It's not for their PLP supporters.
Yeah.
Right? It's only for them.
And what we saw, what's his name? Wayne Monroe do, they went into the bonefish pond area, which they can do because that's an official government area, a protected area. They went into the bonefish pond area allegedly because we didn't see them and no one we talked to saw, come this way so we can put the thing in the background.
Yeah.
No one we talked, come closer because they got here.
Yeah.
No one we talked to saw them in that area. But he said they went in the bonefish pond area and they ain't see nothing. Now, I showed video where stuff was going on, but they said they ain't see nothing. But what really happened is, and we have video, we released that on Sunday too.
They
was on Cowpen Road, standing in the road, pulling cars over as they passed and saying, let me see your ID. And the person didn't have ID, then they were irregular and you had to check them. And that's the persons they say they arrested until someone could bring their ID. All right? They ain't arrest nobody. But the media put up headlines that they've already started clearing people off of Crown Land as if that's what they're doing. They did no such thing. They are pretending and lying, etc. I am waiting on a sign, Maria, that says, y'all are trespassing on Crown Land.
Or forestry.
This is Crown Land. And y'all must cease and desist or remove or move. You have 14 days to move or move immediately. That's what we're waiting on. Your sign does not say that. Your sign only informs people generally that, oh, you cannot, you should not enter, although that ain't the law. No law, so you can't enter a forest. That is the most ridiculous thing. No law, so you can't enter a forest. Now, you can't do certain things in the forest, all right? But that's all it does is inform you to never declare that a forest. And the problem is, they have already done press conferences saying that that is not a forest, so they got problems with that. I just wanted to plug that in there.
Lincoln, the problem is, you remember our advisor tell us, don't say certain things.
Mm-hmm.
Wait for them,
mm-hmm.
and we can see what they got.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Because mm-hmm. for years they've been looking, and what we got, no. We can wait and see what they got.
Yeah. So, Brave, them signs, they null and void, eh? You're not the Minister of Forestry, all right? And you are not the Director of Forestry.
But he is in charge of land.
But you're in charge of Crown Land.
Crown,
so why the sign ain't say nothing but Crown Land?
Thank you.
I thought you'd say we trespassing on Crown Land.
I mean, Monroe, that's what you say he's doing?
Yeah.
So why the sign ain't saying nothing but Crown Land?
They know why.
They know why?
Yeah, they know why.
They know we're waiting on them.
Yeah.
We're waiting on them.
They mm-hmm. talk every day.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah, we're waiting on them.
Talk
so,
every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have officially served, we have officially served documents on the Prime Minister. We've officially served documents on the Minister of National Security, sorry, Minister of National Insurance, and we've officially served documents on the Governor General himself. And on Monday, we are going to be writing to the Queen herself as it relates to our natural resources and the previous, and right, let me get it. We're going to be writing to them. No, we'll stay right here and finish. We can go back in the car. We're going to write to them. Come close. We're going to write to them about the previous commission of inquiry that they have not gone forward with. Honestly, people ask us about it. We had to give this government a chance to do something. They just got in. A lot of things to do, a lot of things to tie up, etc. We had to give them a fair chance. They've now been in, and this is going to be 10 months that they've been in. And so now they've had more than enough chance to have these commissions of inquiry. And so we're not going to be tolerating or entertaining anything else. Our natural resources are being raped and robbed. We have the number one natural resource in the world, which is sand. Only air and water is used more than sand as a natural resource. It is the most used natural resource. The world is running out of it. Why are we broke? Why are we flying around the world, Maria, telling other countries that we broke, that we poor? Why?
See, you know what they're doing? They want the money for themselves. They have to pin this picture of Lincoln.
And why are we selling all of our land, which is a natural resource? Every time Chester Cooper shakes a hand with someone, every time he does that, that's land that's gone forever.
What?
Why are they signing this new carbon credit bill that we will not benefit from? Why?
Mm.
Why are we doing that? It is totally out of order, and it is totally unacceptable. And we will not accept it.
Totally right? Agree with you, Lincoln.
We will not accept it. All right, so... So, ladies and gentlemen, we want, let's get inside, Brave. Sorry, you must be coming down. Yeah, Brave must be coming down, Maria. They must be telling me I'll serve something, isn't it?
Yeah, must be.
Yeah. Hey, how you doing?
How are you?
Good to see
you.
Good,
right here.
All right. So, they start Brave's car, so they must be coming down, so they're lining up cars behind him.
Watch this.
Behind his car.
Watch this, Lincoln. Read this, boy, look at him, more I read. Watch what the Prime Minister Brave Davis says. This is Brave Davis?
Yeah, that's him.
Right? He said this April the 14th, 2022.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted to increase national insurance. Look what the Prime Minister said. Read that.
He says national insurance has so much money, they have to put it in non-interest bearing accounts in the central bank just to have somewhere to lodge it. And so if you look at the returns they've gotten over the years, from government projects, there has been a decent rate of return.
What? Thank
in
you.
In some cases, returns as much as 8 to 9%. So any financial advisor who says national insurance was used as a slush fund, I think you need to check their credibility. We definitely need a commission of inquiry now.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank
you very much. Because he given something conflicted. Miles Loder given something conflicted.
And NIB giving something conflicting.
Yes.
They are telling their staff they ain't got no money.
Thank you.
This man said, man, NIB got so much money.
Thank you, Ray. Oh, just what God. The Prime Minister said. We are doing our research, Bahamians. We got our research team. The young generation doing the research. I'm coming up with this. Just what our Prime Minister said. They got so much money. Huh? So why the people them can't get their benefits?
We can save the rest for Sunday.
Yeah, we can save the rest for Sunday.
Some stuff for you.
But they're going to eat up now, but
all right, them to know who they are.
Thank you.
He ain't coming now right now.
He's a
but anyway,
man.
Nice shark in the country. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you for joining us.
Yes.
Thank you for being with us to take this awesome stand. No, we didn't announce it because we didn't want them to know what we was doing the stand.
Thank you.
You know, they like to block and certain stuff, but we are taking a real stand. All right, we are standing for our natural resources. We are standing for our natural resources. We're giving the government a chance to do what they have to do. All right, because I had conversations with Ray before the election. All right, I sat with him before election. And so certain things we expected. All right, we are expecting carbon credits, but we expect to benefit from it. We are expecting for Bahamians to get access to Crown land and for there to be a process, an actual law on Crown land and an actual protest for applying for this Crown land. That is what we are looking forward to. All right, and so we're not going to be dealing with one thing. We have a whole entire country to run. So on Sunday, we're going to put out some more stuff. We're going to thank all of you for being here.
This Shane Gibson waking here. Shane Gibson talking, asked about claim from some NIB had used a slush fund or Mr. Green. He said no. If you look at it, NIB right now is worth
$2 billion.
In what? Assets or money?
So they asked Shane Gibson if NIB is used as a slush fund. He said, no, they got $2 billion in NIB.
Money or assets? They checking us, Lincoln. We need to find whether this is money or assets.
Yeah.
Man, Lincoln, we got a lot to talk about.
Yeah, Sunday. Sunday, make sure be there with us. We got to drop some files. Sunday at 5 p.m., make sure you're there. This is serious. It's going to affect all of us. Their proposal is to increase national insurance to just under 38% of your salary. It's 9.8% now. Now, it's 9.8%.
Hold on a second.
And they plan on increasing it by 28%.
I need to go back again and find out something.
Yeah, for fucking years.
Is Shane Gibson waking you?
No, he ain't working.
Yeah,
he's advising us.
Philip Brandon, that's there he is.
How you doing, man?
This article, you need to find this something. Right. Is Mr. Shane Gibson working here? Could you call? What is Shane Gibson's position here? Because looking at this article, Mr. Shane Gibson responded to this article along with the PM. We, the Bahamian people, would like to know if Shane Gibson is working here on behalf of the Bahamian people and what is his position here?
You speaking to me?
Yes, ma'am. Shane,
did
you know what I'm here?
No, I didn't.
Could you call the minister, the prime minister's secretary, please? Anybody else here to tell us whether Mrs. Shane Gibson working here? Get us to BS, please. Lincoln, look at this. This was the research you come up with. You see?
Yes, sir. He's $2 billion in NIB.
My former Minister of Labor yesterday, he was able to talk. We would like to know. We need to speak to Mr. Gibson.
To who?
Mr. Shane Gibson. Is the PS here? How is it, Mr. Shane Gibson, the former minister, is responding to this article along with the PM? Miss Molly, petition, please. Excuse me now. You say your name is Miss Molly? What is your first name? Bridget Molly? Could you please tell me what is your position in the office of the Prime Minister? You're his assistant. Who's the permanent secretary? Is he in? He's not assistant. Could you tell me now if Mr. Sheen Gibson, the former minister, for what? Not sure and sure, worked in this building? Do we work in the office of the prime minister? So, but he's giving a statement, so you don't know if Mr. Sheen Gibson is working for the government? What do you want for Mr. Davis, please? I can bring downstairs. No problem, ma'am. Bridget Money, she said bring downstairs. Maintenance. This is our prime minister. See? The young people in this country is going to cost this government. We have a research team. I never knew till we went to go into the car that this is one of the documents that the research team found. This is our prime minister. Make what they say, April the 14th, 2022. We toured everything in here with the words of our prime minister. Well, what happened? As we read down, Mr. Sheen Gibson giving a lot of statements on behalf of the government. So we come here now to find out whether Mr. Sheen Gibson work here. Because he's talking that National Insurance got $2 billion. We need to know whether there's $2 billion in assets or money. We, the workers, need to know what's going on. Trust me, Mr. Gibson, not a lot to say. We come here to find what's going on. Is this man wicked for the Bahamas government? This is unacceptable in this country. We need to know what's going on with our NIB money. Too much skullduggery. And that's all we need to find, as you know. The permanent secretary, Davis, we need to know. That's all we need to know.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Good day. Everybody around here, but you know me. How are you doing?
Right.
I'm fine. Well, you know Mr. Sheen Gibson work here?
No.
Yeah.
Well,
that ain't the story. Let's go. That ain't the story.
All right, so, and I don't want to sign. See,
yeah.
You went to England. You live in England for a while. You live in the U.S. for a while.
Yes.
I read in the media that stories, when someone says something, they cross-check it.
Thank you.
They check and see if this is the case, and they check to see who this person is and what's their credentials and their credibility. All right? If Sheen Gibson says it's $2 billion in the fund, and then later people are coming and saying that the fund is broke, You got to question that.
Thank you very much.
You got to question that. Where you get this information from? Sometimes you just want to, give up on this country, but you can't.
No, we can't give up.
Because it ain't make, the country don't make no sense. So we got to fix this.
We got to fix this, and we need answers.
We just want to get that straight. You saw the prime minister came out, but he didn't get served. We served him his documents, so I had nothing to say to him. We gave him his papers, and we're going to do what we have to do.
So we're going to do more research, right? We're going to do more. And by the way, don't worry where these documents coming from. Don't come and try to put a search on me and Lincoln, because we've sent 5 and 6 copies all over the place.
We've had several meetings this week on me and you.
Thank you. All for right? What?
So there's more.
We are lightweight.
There's more threats as it relates to me and you. All right? But
Ladies and gentlemen, we're willing to stand up for this. And we don't care how much leads they have, how much stress they have, how much they're trying to find some way to lock us up, set us up, kill us, whatever it is they think they want to do. That's on them.
That's right.
All right? We are going to stand up for the Bahamian people and who don't like it, too bad. Who think we're doing this for politics? Too bad. Who think we're doing this to get elevated? Too bad. All right? We are doing this because no one else wants to do it.
They don't want to ask hard questions.
Whoever thinks that we're not good enough to stand up for the Bahamian people, that we're not dressed well enough, we're not handsome and pretty enough, all right, that we're not smart enough, we're not intelligent enough, we're not eloquent enough, too bad. We're going to do it until the qualified people come on board.
That's right.
Someone got to do it. All right? So if you have someone else who can take on this battle and stand up for the people and not sell out, then you please send them.
Yes.
If they are eloquent and they're able to pontificate and they're able to speak the Queen's English very well, then you send them. If they're handsome and beautiful and their hair is always perfect because they have the time and they're not like us out there fighting for the people all day, every day. They have the time to spend 4 hours in the hairdresser and the barbershop. Then you send them.
Thank you.
All right, but until then, we are going to stand up for the Bahamian people because our country is in peril. We are under invasion. Our people are being robbed and raped every single day, and they're trying to keep us as a nation of a plantation.
Thank you.
That's what they're trying to keep us. But it's time for us to rise up. It's
time
for us to stand up. Well, I am going to stand up, and I'm going to take my people with me. And
me
so
too.
For those people who are ready for New Bahamas, then let's go. Because this old Bahamas, this ain't working no more.
Thank you very much.
Everything is broken, Maria.
I know.
Nothing works. Nothing. So we're going to fight, and we're going to fix this. People on board, send them. They know the fight. Send them.
Yeah.
Send them. They're not credible because they're sellouts.
Thank you very much.
They're not credible because they're not willing to stand up and fight for this nation. They're not willing to risk their mortgage. They're not willing to risk their little job. They're not willing to risk their contract, like me and Maria. We will stand up for the Bahamian people, and we will bring a country. We will have a country
Thank
that
you.
We are proud to be in. We
That's
will
right.
have a country that puts Bahamian first.
That's right.
I have a dream.
That's right.
I see a new Bahamas.
That's right.
I see a Bahamas where we will benefit from all of our natural resources. I see it, Maria. You see it?
Of course I see it.
I can see it, feel it, smell it, touch
That's
it.
Right.
It is right here, ladies and gentlemen. And I believe in the Bahamas. I'm boycotting this independence because this country ain't for us. All right? But we are going to build the new Bahamas. See you on Sunday.
That's right.
At 5 p.m. Ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
God bless.
Evening.
Ivan, what's up, man? Good to see you.
How you doing, Ivan?
Good to see you.
In the new Bahamas. See you next time. God bless.
It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long